Blackstone Audio presents Marian McPartland's Jazz World, All in Good Time, by Marian McPartland. This book is read by the author. Dedication. Remembering Jamie. Foreword by James T. Marr. When Margaret Marian Turner was a schoolgirl in Bromley, an old market town in the southeastern reaches of Greater London, she was awarded good marks in singing, violin, and piano. The Kentish Times reported during 1934 that Miss Turner gave a lyrical and sincere interpretation of Mendelssohn's song, The First Violet, at the Bromley Music Festival. However, one of her early teachers testily observed that this child is unmanageable. To the great comfort of her many partisans amongst jazz enthusiasts the world around, she has remained so. In the middle 1930s, the able young piano student was accepted at the Guildhall School of Music and Drama in London. There she concentrated on composition and harmony, as well as piano, and there she again went her, if not by then unmanageable, at least unpredictable way. She won the composition scholarship of the Worshipful Company of Musicians, wrote and performed a work for piano which she called, with academic propriety, Valse Gracieuse, and was awarded the Chairman's Pianoforte Prize. Then suddenly, in her third full year, she ducked out one spring day to audition for a musical vaudeville act, using the clandestine name Marian Page, for fear the Guildhall would learn of her aesthetic truancy. She passed the audition and withdrew from the Guildhall formally, but in haste, leaving behind the piano tutelage and good opinion of Orlando Morgan, who despised popular music, calling it rubbish. She had, capriciously in his view, joined Billy Mayle and his Claviers, a four-piano ensemble organized and led by a pianist-composer-promoter then well-known in England. Her rebellious change of direction brought strong protests from her mother and father. They were horrified, she has recalled, but I kept insisting and they finally gave in. The errant Miss Turner, now one of Mayle's popular company of music hall pianists, had not forgotten that she had promised Professor Morgan that she would come back and get on with her serious study of the piano and its literature. But her promise, like many that one makes in youth to one's elders, was fast slipping out of reach. The ex-student had already crossed one of the most seductive thresholds in a musician's life. She had made her first recordings. Further, she had discovered the joys of being one's own musical self. To leap briefly into her future, where she was to be very much herself as a pianist, she joined ENSA, the British counterpart of the USO in World War II, switched to the USO after D-Day, entertained troops within the sound of artillery fire at the battlefront in France, toured Allied facilities with a troop headed by Fred Astaire, performed at Supreme Headquarters, Allied Expeditionary Force, Versailles, for General Eisenhower, and propitiously met and married a famous American jazz trumpet player, Jimmy McPartland, whose flamboyant charm was only slightly constrained by the fact that as a soldier musician, he was then performing under orders in the midst of a war. Enter Marian McPartland. Exit Margaret Marian Turner. Almost. For she insisted, she is a good insister, on being billed as Marian Page in her early jazz career with Jimmy McPartland's various Dixieland Chicago jazz groups. To clarify the matter of her name, she is still known to her family as Maggie. Marian Page? Oh, that was just a name I had made up in London. I can't even remember where it came from. But with Jimmy, I did want to declare my independence as a musician, she has recalled, capping the matter with a witty motte. If it wasn't Women's Lib yet, 1947, at least it was Ad Lib. Leonard Feather, a fellow expatriate and well-known figure in the jazz world as a critic, composer, and record producer, had by then begun tracking Marian's career, carefully and with a certain concern. Writing in Downbeat in 1952.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.